You know what time it is. It's Let's Talk Film time. And of course, your host for the day, Leon Kai, filling in for Kavata. Today at Let's Talk Film, we shall have a conversation with an actor all the way from Los Angeles, California. And his name is Ezekiel. So Ezekiel, good morning.
Good morning. How's it going?
It's going well. How is it over there?
I'm doing well. Doing fantastic, actually. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I see you have many projects coming up, but we'll talk about that much later in the show. How is the weather? How is everything feeling?
Oh, man, the weather's great. It's like, yeah. I believe it's like maybe 75, 76 degrees out here in LA.
Yeah.
The sun is shining. You know, people are out, you know, walking their dogs and stuff like that. So, yeah. It's great. Everything's good.
All right. So many Kenyan people or most of our viewers might not know who you are. So would you like to introduce yourself a little bit to the Kenyan people?
Sure. Yeah. Why not? So my name is Ezekiel Ajeigbe. But if you pronounce it with the accent, it's Ezekiel Ajeigbe with the Nigerian accent. Yeah. So I'm a young professional actor here in Los Angeles. I'm first generation Nigerian. So my parents moved from Nigeria to the States and then had me. I was the first in my family to actually be born here in the United States. I was actually born in Texas. I've been acting I started my journey officially in 2014, I believe, summer of 2014. But unofficially, I've been acting literally my entire life since I was a kid, you know, just being a character or impersonating somebody since I was young. I love what I do. I do what I love. And here I am talking to you guys.
Yeah. So what inspired you to become an actor?
For me to become an actor? So I believe it started when I was either 7 or 8. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with the show, but I was watching, it was either the 90s or 2000 series called All That or Kenan and Kel. Yeah, or Kenan and Kel with, there's an actor, at that time he was young, he was like a teenager or a kid. His name is Kenan Thompson, I believe, Kenan Thompson. And at that time I used to watch people like Eddie Murphy, Will Smith, you know, Martin Lawrence and stuff, but they were older. They were like adults. So yeah. When I saw Kenan on the screen, that was like the first time I saw a kid, like a young black boy on TV. And I was looking at him, I was like, man, how come he's on TV and I'm not? I can do that. I can do it better than him. So I started doing exactly what he's doing. And from there, I guess that's where I just had it set in my mind and in my heart that acting is something I wanted to do. Like, I want to be on TV. Ever since then, that's just been my goal, my dream.
And since then, you haven't gone on any other different path? You haven't thought of becoming a doctor or a pilot like most young people?
So, of course, you know, as a child of immigrants from the motherland, my parents, of course, they wanted me to become a doctor, an engineer, or a lawyer, or a pilot. You know, even I remember growing up, I used to always say I wanted to be a pharmacist, knowing good and well I didn't care about pharmacy. I wanted to act, you know, but I'm just saying what any kid would say to make their parents happy. I tried it, but it wasn't for me. It wasn't for me. My passion and my heart was elsewhere. So
did your parents follow through with it after you decided and you told them that you wanted to become an actor? Did they support you, or was it you have to be a pharmacist?
Oh man, that was like one of the hardest conversations I ever had to have in my life, was to tell my parents the truth of what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
Because I was, that time I was in, I think what, it was maybe 2016, 2017. I was still in school. I was studying electrical engineering and technology. I hated it. I was miserable in school. I was, you know, depressed, all of this stuff. And so like one day I went home to tell my parents the truth. I was like, man, I just want to act. I want to be an actor. Like, I'm an entertainer. This is just a part of who I am. It's not who I am. It's a part of me. You know what I mean? So when I told them that, you know, we're going back and forth, we're arguing. You know, they were saying stuff like, you know, you will not make it. You will never make it unless you graduate, you know, and get your degree. I was like, but this is what I want to do. I don't want to, you know, struggle and be this engineer that you're trying to make me be. And they said, no pain, no gain. I was like, no, that's not the way it works. It's only pain and gain if it's for something that you're passionate about. But if you don't care about it, doesn't, the pain is hurting you. So we went back and forth. They were telling me things like, you know, you won't make it. We will not support you unless you graduate, you know, all this stuff. So the support wasn't there. You know, I took a leap of faith because I just felt it in my spirit that, you know, entertainment was my calling, was part of my calling. And that was what I was supposed to be doing. So eventually I left. I left school at the time. And I started pursuing acting full time, and I never looked back since. And two, three years later, you know, here I am.
So, doing a lot of stuff. So you never ended up actually graduating. So no to college and everything.
I left in my third year. My third year, I left.
And you never looked back.
Never looked back.
Man, that is amazing. Okay, for me personally, I know some of your projects because I follow you heavy, but for some of us, for the viewers, they might not know your projects. So could you mention a few projects you've worked on?
Yeah, for sure. So I've been on The House Invictus. I play Jide on The House Invictus. I believe that's on Amazon Prime right now. I play Young Jeff on Dynasty, which is on Netflix. I'm in season one, episode 20. That's where you'll be able to see me. So Jeff Colby, he's one of the series regulars, so he's in every episode, but I play the younger version of him. So with all the flashbacks, that's when I come in and play like his younger self. I'm also in, I have a little cameo in All American, which is also on Netflix, season two, episode one. You'll see me there as well. I'm on a show called SEAL Team for CBS. Central Broadcasting Station, I believe that's what's the acronym mean. That is either on their website or it's like streaming somewhere. I'm not too sure. I've also done, man, I feel like I need to pull up my old resume to to remember everything I've done. But yeah, I've done a handful of movies, shows, shorts. I actually just got done doing a virtual reality project called Breaking Ground with a very, very good director. I've done a lot of stuff. I've done a lot of stuff, yeah.
This is what we're one of. This is what was foretold. The Lord said their flesh will rot away while they're standing, and their eyes shall rot away. Their tongues shall rot away inside their mouths. The Lord said there will be a plague of blood. The stench of death will rise from every village. Sinners will be besieged.
It'd be nice if he threw in sports and weather now and then.
The fuck out of here.
It's gonna be something downstairs. I got you.
Oh, hey, man. What's going on?
Yo, D. You all right, man?
Dumb. And being a reckless will put him 6 feet under, right? Do you really think that's gonna get me respect?
I mean, it makes people think twice about crossing you.
Because of fear, man. You don't get respect through fear. I mean, look what happened to Pops. That's what happens when people stop fearing you. That sound like respect to you? That was his life. We'll make ours.
Got
it. Hey, watch.
What's up? We're gonna need that back, all right? We're just gonna take it and be gone. I told you already. Get out of here, Vic. I got this. Go!
Cross the dread. Flee the red.
So how is it actually on set? When you're actually shooting and how everything is going?
Yeah, set life is nice. It's nice, especially if you're one of the talent, if you're one of the actors, they treat you like you're royalty. You know, anything you need, anything you ask for, somebody will get it for you. It's just amazing. You know, they really pamper you. But now because of COVID, it's really strict. You know, and it's really different. It's different from what it used to be because of the whole pandemic that's going on. But it's great. It's amazing. Food, anything you can eat, anything you want to eat, it's there. Anything you want to drink, it's there. They have anything for you. It's amazing.
But Ezekiel, I'm a little bit curious. What's the craziest thing you've ever asked for on set?
The craziest thing I've ever asked for. I'm very low maintenance, so like I don't really ask for too much because I don't want to put a burden on anybody. Like I think the most was when I was going in for just a fitting. You know, I was only gonna be there for 30 minutes. The assistant lady, she asked me, "Hey, do you want anything?" And I was like, "Honestly, if I can get some fruit, I'm craving some fruit right now." So she went wherever she needed to go, and she came back with a big, you know, thing, big platter of just fruit just for me. And I was like, whoa, I wasn't expecting you to give me all of this. She was like, no, it's okay. This is for you. Just take it. I was like, wow. All I was doing was, you know, going for a fitting. I wasn't even filming or anything that day. But yeah, I guess that would be the craziest thing. But usually I don't really ask for much because I tend to try to keep a calm, you know, cool collective environment for everybody. I don't want to work anybody too hard.
Yeah, it was a type of mama, I made it moment for you. So, like, have you worked with any Kenyan artists?
Yeah, I have, actually. So my boy Silas Mwenda, we did a movie in 20, I believe that was 2016, we did a movie in Colorado Springs, I believe. And he played one of my co-stars in the movie. He's one of my co-stars in the movie. He's a great actor, great guy, phenomenal. My boy Raymond Watanga, he's also a friend of mine. We haven't done like a serious project yet, but we've done like, you know, little stuff for Instagram and YouTube and stuff like that. He's actually one of my roommates. He's not here today, but yeah, he's really good. He was on the show SWAT. I believe Kenya had like some newspaper article about him doing SWAT a while ago. So yeah, he's good people as well. Raymond Watanga.
All right. So is there, the question that I have more so is there like a celebrity moment where the, like, people know you, people want to get your autograph and something like that?
So in 2018, there was somebody, I think the very, very first person I gave my autograph, it was some lady. I guess she was a fan of my work. She messaged me on Instagram and she was like, "Hey, can I have your autograph?" At first I thought she was just playing, you know, I thought it was a joke. And she was like, "No, I'm serious. I really want your autograph. Like, can you send me one? Like, I'll give you my address. Just send me like your autograph." I was like, "Oh man, this girl is serious. This is crazy. I've never had this before." So I get one of my photos, one of my pictures. I don't think I have one with me, but I get one of my pictures and then I sign it and then I ship it to her. And whenever she got it, she messaged me back saying, you know, "Thank you so much. I'm a fan of your work," you know, all this stuff. So that it was a really cool experience. But like in person, not really. People, I mean, I have, but they're from like my friends and I feel like they're just playing around. They're not serious.
Have you come up to Africa yet?
Not yet. My parents, growing up, my parents used to always say, "We'll go one day as a family. Just, you know, pray for us," stuff like that. But we never actually went. They go all the time. My mom and my dad, they go all the time to Nigeria. But me, my brother, my sister, we haven't been together because I believe it's maybe like 2,000-3,000 per person. So for the entire family, you're looking at least, you know, 18,000 to 20,000 just for a round trip, you know, to go. Yeah.
But if you were to get to Africa and specifically Kenya, would you like to do a few projects here?
Of course. Yeah, why wouldn't I? Of course. As long as the story is good, as long as the quality is there, you know, I'm all for it.
Do you already have like do you have a picture of who you would like to do a project with?
That's a good question. In Africa specifically?
Yeah, in Africa.
I would like to do. That's a good question. No, I don't think I have any specific, you know, African actors or actresses that I really want to do a project. Yeah, no, not yet.
All right, to digress a little bit, personally, if I were to do a project up there with an African, I probably would go Idris Elba.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's nice. That's like on the top complete. But also Silas, I think so. And now that I know you, is a definite.
Nice. Yeah, Silas is good people. He's good people.
Yeah. So, like, what keeps you in the industry? Because I know the industry is harsh everywhere. So what actually keeps you going? What keeps you motivated? What keeps you looking forth?
Okay. So, like, I usually tell a lot of people that regardless of what field you go into and what it is you're trying to do in your life, you need to make sure that you love it, that you're passionate about it. Because if you don't and you're not, then you're going to burn out as soon as, you know, it gets tough or as soon as it gets hard. So for me specifically, I understand that. At first, you know, it was just a dream, right? At first, it started out as a dream, and then the dream started becoming a reality. And it wasn't until I was doing, I can't remember what I was doing. I think I was in a class or something, and I was performing for like the students or something like that. And after my performance, everybody in the audience was crying, and I was in my head, I was confused. I was like, why are they crying? And then the teacher stopped me and she was like, you know, you see what you just did to all these people? Like, they're all crying because of what you just did, you know, your performance. It was so amazing. And in my head, it clicked. That was like a me and God moment. It just clicked. And I realized that, you know, the gifts and talents that I have is not just for me. It's also for others, you know? Part of my calling is to, I guess, reach people through my art, reach the masses through my art. So there may be something somebody's going through, something somebody's like battling with in their real life, but the character that I'm playing, you know, they can relate to that. They can look at my character and find healing or find restoration or find, you know, some type of thing to where it makes them know, okay, if that character can get through it, I can too. So after I realized that, it made me know and understand that it's not just about me anymore. It's about these other people who are out there who need to be reached. Because I feel like if I fail to say yes to becoming an actor, then every single person that I was meant to touch and I was meant to reach and I was meant to grasp within every single performance that I would have done as an actor would never be reached. And I would have failed as a person in a way. So that right there keeps me going because I know that it's not just about me anymore. And also I love it. You know, I love what I do. It's been a passion of mine since I was a kid. So
have you ever been pushed to a wall such that you actually think of quitting? Like you think, I'm gonna go home now. This is it. This is as far as I go.
Yeah, many times. When I first left school and I had no supports from my friends, my family, my parents, I was literally on my own. I think I was maybe 21 at the time. I moved to Atlanta, Georgia by myself to do a movie. And I think that entire year, 2017, transitioning into 2018 was one of the hardest years of my life. Because I was, man, a lot was going wrong. Like the movie that I was supposed to, you know, due for 6 months. I come to find out that they recasted me in month like two, and now I basically gave up my life in Texas, left everything I love, I knew, just to do this, just to find out that I'm no longer what they're looking for, or I'm no longer, you know, going to do that project. So I was lost. I was like, I was angry. I was angry at God. I was angry at myself. I was like, why did I leave everything to do this, just for it to be taken away from me? You know? So I was thinking, man, I need to figure something out. I need to figure something out. At that time, you know, I wasn't really doing many projects because I was really dedicating myself to that one project. And from there, like, I was going through a lot of internal conflict. Yeah. You know, I believe at that time I would, because I didn't have the support, I was staying like, I think, on someone's couch for a while. And I was just looking at my surroundings and just looking at my environment and things around me. And I was like, man, is this really for me? Is this really what I'm supposed to be doing? And I thought about quitting many times because it was a lot of tough days, you know, days where, you know, I was wondering, well, when am I going to have my next meal? When am I going to eat? You know, I know what it feels like to be hungry. And I was thinking, man, is this really what I'm supposed to be doing? I was always contemplating that, you know, crying, praying, you know, trying to get some answer, you know? So yeah, in those moments early on in the beginning, you know, I was really, really on the wall, really on the fence, thinking about giving up. But my girlfriend at the time, she was the only person that supported me. I take that back. She was the only person that supported me. At that time, even though I was going through those things, she kept pushing me and motivating me, saying, hey, you can do this. You got this. You didn't just you didn't just get on this path for no reason. You know, you're here for a reason. So although you're going through these things, just know that things will work itself out. And she was still in Texas, so we were doing long distance for like maybe 2-3 years. We're not together anymore, but we're still great friends. So yeah, through that time, you know, hearing her positive words, even though there was so much negativity around me in the reality, it kept me going. But I really didn't want to quit.
I can imagine. I guess that's the first time you saw the harshness of the film industry, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. It was crazy.
So other than your girlfriend supporting you, what else could you say got you through that moment? Is there anything significant that happened?
Say that one more time.
Is there anything significant that happened, like an awe moment that got you through that?
I would say, as I was going through all those tough times, for whatever reason, I started meeting, you know, people in the industry. Like at that time, I was working at like a phone store, electronic store, because I was the electronic technician. And oddly enough, a lot of people who were like famous or were on TV were coming into the store just to get their phone fixed or their electronic fixed. And my manager specifically told me, none of these people or nobody like this of this caliber have ever came into this store until you started working here. So I started thinking, am I attracting these kind of people into this store? Like, what's going on? So like when that started happening, you know, I started, I guess, connecting the dots within my own personal journey. And I was like, okay, maybe this is something I'm supposed to do because I'm starting to meet these people. And I'm starting to network with these people. I guess that was essentially kind of confirmation that I was where I needed to be. Because like I said before, she was telling me, my manager was telling me, no, none of that's never happened for them until I started working there. So I was thinking, okay, maybe I should be here. Maybe this is exactly where I need to be. So let me just keep pushing regardless of what my reality looks like.
That's amazing. Seems like that was a message from God that was sent to you.
Yeah.
But then what would you tell young actors who want to follow in your steps? What would you tell them to do, basically?
Young actors, I'll always tell people, you know, if acting is really something you want to do, if acting is something that's in your heart, that's a part of you, just as an entertainer, period, to just follow your dreams, man. Just follow your dreams. No matter what anybody tells you, what anybody has to say, negative, whatever, you know, follow your dreams. If it's really something you want to do, go for it. The sky's the limit. Because in my life, I had so many people telling me not to do it. So many people saying I would never make it. You know, I heard people telling me I was wasting my life. Somebody told me I was a waste of a life because this is what I wanted to do with it. And man, it was tough, you know, hearing those things. But I knew in my heart that this was my calling, that this is, you know, part of what I'm supposed to do in my life. So just hold strong to that feeling and make sure that it's really something that you want to do, because it's not easy. I'll tell you right now, it's not easy. But never give up. Never give up, because hard work really does pay off. And always have faith.
All right. When did your first break come through?
My first break. I would say my very first thing that was big for me was Dynasty. When I did Dynasty. Funny enough, Dynasty I got solely because the guy who plays Jeff, the actual Jeff Colby, he was one of the guys who came into the store that I met during my work time there, and we just connected. And then 3 months later, you know, they're casting for a younger him. I see it, I screenshot it, and I send it to him because we were friends by that time. And I was just trying to congratulate him because I thought it was cool that it said looking for young Sam Adegoki or young Jeff Colby. I was like, man, this is cool. They have your name in this casting thing. That's dope. And he told me, you know what, man? I think you'd be good for this. And I was like, whoa, I wasn't trying to ask you for any handouts. I was just congratulating you because, you know, I want to be able to get to that level one day where it has my name and it says looking for a young Ezekiel JB. I thought that was really cool. But he was like, no, seriously, man, just send me your information. I'll send it to the producers and see if I can get you in. And so he did that. Next day, they called me to come into the studio to do an audition. And then the weekend passed. Monday came. They said, hey, you got the role. My agent called me and said, hey, they want you. So, yeah, that was a good moment for me. That was, like, my first big thing. Because that was the first time I ever, like, had a trailer. First time, you know, I had like an assistant tell who I can tell anything. You know, it was great.
Yeah.
So have you, as an actor, I have to ask this though. As an actor, have you had a wow moment with another actor? Like probably you've met someone like Tom Cruise or Johnny Depp and you've gone like, oh my goodness, this is the person.
Not yet. I've worked with a lot of great actors, but I don't think I take that back. I was on set. I was just working background, though. I was on set with Viola Davis and John Amos. And just watching them perform, there was a few other known actors there as well. But those were like the main OGs that were in the building because they've been doing this for years, right? So I was watching Viola specifically just to like see how she is because they were just rehearsing, and I was like, man, literally I'm in the room with Viola Davis, she's literally like 6 feet away from me. This is crazy to see her in her element. I'm literally studying her, like I'm like taking notes, watching what she does and seeing how she acts and how she interacts. And man, she was killing it in those rehearsals because she was the only one that was really off book. Didn't have a script in her hand, none of that. And it was just rehearsals, which just showed me, man, she really takes this stuff seriously. Everybody else, you know, they had the script in their hand and whatnot. But man, it was amazing. That was like my wild moment. Like, okay, this is what I need to get onto this level. You know, just for rehearsal, I'm already ready. I'm already prepared to perform as if it's performance day.
Yeah.
So that was my first wild moment.
Another question that I have to ask: if you would go back to your career, what's the one thing that you would wish you'd done different?
The one thing that I wish I would have done before.
Yeah. The one thing that you think would have changed you or would have made your career go in a different path?
I don't take back anything that I've experienced or that I've done, nor would I want to add anything either, because I feel like everything that's happened and everything that's transpired was part of what made me into the man I am today.
Yeah.
So the only thing that I could possibly say is maybe in the beginning I would have kept doing like skits and Vine videos and YouTube videos when I was first getting started. Because maybe that would have made a bigger difference in where I am today. Because a lot of people that were also, because I used to be a Viner. I don't know if Vine ever reached Kenya or Africa or anything like that. But like, I used to be a Viner. I was a Viner back in the day when Vine was popular. And some of the people that I used to make videos with or that were making videos at the same time as me, now these guys are like, they've blown up, you know, they have 1 million, 2 million followers on Instagram. They're getting signed by the biggest agencies in acting when they're not even like, you know, fully acting like that. They're just making videos. So like, I feel like if I would have kept doing it and I would have never stopped, I could probably be in those same positions and be in a place where I have leverage because I've built my brand to this certain level.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So as we come to a close of the conversation, what's the one thing that you would tell people? What's the parting shot that you have for people?
As we close, I would just like to say to everybody watching, guys, do what you love. Love what you do. Put God first. Have faith. The sky's the limit. You know, everybody's on their own specific journey. And as long as you follow your passion, follow your heart, that journey will unfold and show you what's next ahead of you. So.
Thank you so much, Ezekiel. It was wonderful having the conversation with you. And guys, that was Ezekiel all the way from LA, California. Ezekiel, have a good day. And to Kenya, good night. Of course, my name is Leon Kai, and the show, Let's Talk Film, powered by Own It.